in what you do and what you've chosen to do by working with junior hires. I was studying in the Bible and I just felt compelled to share a little passage that I was reading the other day with you guys, and hopefully it challenges you. It has two characters in it, and you know, I was kind of torn with these two guys, these two people in here, and they both kind of spoke to me in their position. So here we go. This is in Acts, and Acts 9, and it starts off with Saul, and it says, as he was nearing Damascus on this mission, suddenly a brilliant light from heaven spotted down on him, and he fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, Paul, Paul, why are you persecuting me? Who is speaking? Paul asked. And the voice replied, I am Jesus, the one you are persecuting. Now get up and go into the city and wait my further instructions. The men with Paul stood speechless and surprised, for they heard sound of someone's voice, but saw no one. As Paul picked himself up off the ground, he found that he had been blinded. He had to be led into Damascus and was there 3 days, blinded, going without food and water for all that time. Now in Damascus, there was a believer named Ananias. The Lord spoke to him in a vision, calling, Ananias, yes, Lord. And the Lord said, go over to Straight Street and find the house of a man named Judas and ask there for Paul of Tarsus. He is praying to me right now, for I have shown him a vision of a man named Ananias coming in and laying hands on him so that he can see again. But Lord, explained Ananias, I have heard about the terrible things this man has done to the believers in Jerusalem. And we hear that he arrests and has warrants against believers in Damascus. But the Lord said, go and do what I say, for Paul is my chosen instrument to take my message to the nations and before the kings, as well as the people of Israel. And I will show him how much he must suffer for me. Ananias. I heard this character and I thought to myself, wow. Have I ever worn that hat? Have I ever thought, Lord, why me? Have you seen this junior hire? He's totally out of control. Why me? This girl, and she's just gossiping all the time. I'm like, are you crazy? I'm done with it. I've heard enough. But God's calling us. He's calling each and every one of you. I don't know what the circumstances are for you guys. I don't know what that problem is, what the challenge gonna be, but you're called. You need to step up to the game and just charge hard, because the Lord's going to be with you no matter what happens. This other character here kind of challenged me too. You know, Paul of Tarsus, Saul, came from this pedigree of great background, right? We're talking about, he grew up in a church where they had the best speaking pastors. He had Chris Browns, he had Larry, he had Christopher Hilkins. Those kinds of guys were teaching to him. Guys that knew the Bible inside and out. It says that he went to a university where he learned the Bible inside and out. I don't know, was that university like the School of Ministry? Or you guys, some of you may be getting fed. But yet, for some reason, it says that he had scales on his eyes and he was blinded. I read that and I thought to myself, where am I blinded? Are there things in my life that are blinding me to the good things that God wants me to see or be doing? Are there behavior things that I do and how I treat others? I don't know what it is for you guys. Paul obviously had a fervent love for the word. He just missed Jesus. And I felt challenged that, man, is there an area of my life, though I'm fervent and I love to serve and I'm at North Coast Church and I'm in a growth group and I get fed and I do all that, is there an area of my life that I haven't given to him? An area that I keep secret? So I would challenge you guys to look at yourself and see if there's any area, a scale somewhere on your eyes, some area of your life that you haven't seen, that maybe you need to just give to the Lord. You guys are empowered with an incredible opportunity, and you're going to have opportunities all summer long with the activities you have to build relationships with these young people. It's just like, I look at where I'm at in my life and where you guys are at. It's amazing that you guys are doing this. I wasn't in your seat when I was your age. And I look back now and say, what kept me out of that seat? What kinds of things did I have in my life that were blinding me from pursuing the true passion? So I hope you guys leave from this weekend true passion and hunger, like you feel right now for the food that's going to hit the table, right? You feel that hunger for the students that God trusted me this year. Let me go ahead and pray for the meal. I'll pray that and I'll tell you what we got going on. Hey Lord, we just thank you. Thank you for this place that you've given us. Sound of the ocean, salt air, this evening, and it's perfect in its own way. You've given it to us and you've created it. Thank you for the team of people that are here to serve. And we just pray for this food, that it would be a blessing to everyone that's here, that they would feel honored by the evening and valued. And we just give our time tonight to you. In Christ's name, amen.
Amen.
All right. Always wanted to cook at this site. This is something that we've first time here. If you didn't know that, it's always been exciting for me. And I always thought, man, we get the point. We get the site. We're doing a surf and turf, man. So we got New York strips for you guys tonight. Shrimp scampi's gonna hit the plate. We got some veggies. We got a special potato dish and a lovely starter, a salad coming out. So here's how it's going to work. It's the salad's going to come out plated. We're actually going to serve you the salad. And but the rest of the meal is going to be coming out pretty much a more family style in a bowl that will hit the table. And you guys are just going to self-serve and go. So we've got some beverages over here. Feel free to float up. And that's it. So we're going to turn the music up and start the evening rolling.
Yeah, woo!